passage of scripture that involves folks getting bit by vipers. Many of them died, but God provided a remedy. And that entire experience was foreshadowing something that is still in full effect today. Let's go to the book of Numbers, chapter 21. Let's begin at verse 5. Look at this. And the people spake against God and against Moses. Wherefore have you brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? And there is no bread, neither is there any water. And our soul loathes this light bread. And the Lord sent fiery serpents among the people, and they bit the people, and much people of Israel died. Therefore, the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord and against you. Pray unto the Lord that he take away the serpents from us." And Moses prayed for the people. And the Lord said unto Moses, "Make a fiery serpent, and set it upon a pole. And it shall come to pass that every one that is bitten, when he looks upon it, shall live." And Moses made a serpent of brass, and put it upon a pole. And it came to pass that if a serpent had bitten any man, when he beheld the serpent of brass, he lived. I want you to see how that experience of Israel impacts all of us today. We can see clearly that sin has a penalty of death. When the children of Israel spoke against God and Moses, the Lord sent those fiery serpents, the vipers, and those vipers bit the people, and many of them died, right? At some point, the children of Israel figured out that the reason that these vipers were biting folks, the reason why folks were dying as a result, was due to their sin. They made the connection. See, they recognized that sin was the root cause of death, and death came through those vipers. Now, Moses was instructed by the Lord to take this representation of the penalty of sin and post it up, this brass serpent. And if anyone was bitten by the vipers, all they had to do was look upon that representation of sin with the penalty of death, and they would live. They had been dying. They were dying from the snake bite as a result of sin. But now, all they had to do was follow the instructions of God, look upon the representation of sin and its death penalty, look upon it and believe that by faith they would live. They should be dead. Their sin had a consequence of death. But if they believed in what God had provided, some of you already see this. This foreshadowing is of Jesus Christ and his work on the cross. The brass serpent posted up upon that pole was not a real viper. In and of itself, it committed no sin. It was a representation of death as a result of sin. To get bitten by a real viper, look upon the brass viper and believe that you would live, required faith. The instruction came from the Lord. When Israel sinned, the fiery serpents were sent by the Lord as a penalty of death. So the Lord has the power to follow through with the remedy, the solution, the ability to reverse the curse, to take this cause and effect, this reaction to an action, and set life instead of death. We see this verified even in the New Testament, Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus our Lord.